Oh, dearie me, guys. This card is very, very expensive. Lev Yashin's Winter Wildcard has came as an SBC today. 16 squads for this card. But let me tell you, this card is unbelievable in game. Are you tired of coming up against absolutely insane teams? Well, today I've got a solution for you. Welcome to lootbar.gg, the fastest, safest, and most reliable, as well as cheapest coins I have seen for FC24. You can receive your coins as fast as 30 minutes, and also they offer full refunds if you're not happy with the product. Here is me making an order of 100,000 coins. As you can see, as we go across to the game, I've only got 489,000 coins. I also got a message from the customer service team, and they told me exactly what I need to do to get my coins. And there we have it, guys. Just like that, in about 20 minutes, I have received my 100,000 coins. Not only that, they offer 24/7 customer support, so if you do need help with your order, you are in good hands. You can also trust lootbar.gg with a 4.6 rating on Trustpilot and absolutely amazing reviews, which you can see right now on your screen. So if you want to upgrade your team on FC24, make sure you go to lootbar.gg, link in the description. Now, if you're wondering, guys, how I know how good Lev is in game, I've used him on a pro RTG account. 6'2", medium high, 2-star skills, 3-star weak foot with the controlled accelerate type. Stick with me here, because I know when you look at the base card stats, he doesn't look very good. 85 pace, 71 passing, 76 dribbling, 88 defending, and 91 physical. He's also not got the best playstyles in the world, really. You know, he's got 4 out of the 6 for defending playstyles, which is important. Specifically, Jockey is really good. We'll get into why shortly. Block Plus is terrible. I don't care what anybody says. That's a terrible playstyle. Plus, Intercept and Anticipate is really, really nice to see, as well as Relentless. He can only play centre-back, as you'd expect. He's got the Chemistry Style GK Basic on right now. As we go into the in-games, I like the pace split. I like the 90 acceleration. It's better than sprint speed on this game. So to have that as a weird split, an acceleration coming up on top, is nice. You'd rather have it a bit more close together, but still, 90 acceleration is very, very nice. He's got 99 vision, but absolutely terrible passing. Now, his passing isn't that bad in game. You can't trust it too much, but his passing is okay. The thing I love about this card, guys, is how good his dribbling stats are. They don't seem like they're distributed properly, because when you look at them, and then 76 dribbling overall, it seems like it should be like 85 or 86. He's got 98 agility and 94 balance. Amazing for the jockeying, especially with the body type he's got in game and him being 6'2". He's got 99 reactions, which is amazing. 78 ball control and 98 composure. Them dribbling stats are out of this world good and make him a top, top tier centre back. Defensively, he's good, right? You know, he's got great interceptions at 99, or the best you can get. 84 heading accuracy, 85 defense awareness, 85 stand tackle and 84 slide tackle. So quite low on the important defensive stats bar interceptions. He's got 99 jumping with also, you know, the 6'2" frame is awesome. 73 stand, but he does have relentless. 99 strength and 89 aggression. So his physicals are incredible as well. The chem style, guys, for this card is an absolute no-brainer. It's got to be a shadow for this card. Now, the reason the shadow is so good for him, in my opinion, plus 8 to the pace, and he does get the full boost of acceleration there. He hasn't gone over the, 98 still is very, very nice, and 88 sprint speed, taking him up to 93 base pace. The reason the shadow is good for him, guys, in my opinion, is the boost you do get to his defending stats. So up to 89 defensive awareness, 93 stand tackle, and 96 slide tackle, I think is an amazing boost. Yes, he's expensive, but I think he's going to be very good. Let's test him out in game. Alrighty then, guys. So this is actually the second game with Yashin. The first game, I forgot to record, which was absolutely silly from me. But let's get into this one and let's see what our man Yashin can offer. Now, please do understand that I'm really, really aggressive with my centre-backs. And there might be a few times where I overstep or I misread, okay? That is going to happen probably. Oh, my God. Oh! Jesus Christ, I don't know who blocked that. I don't know if it was Yashin. I saw the icon come up that it was the block plus. Nice, nice, nice. And you know what, guys? All things considered, his passing isn't that bad. You know, it's more about the composure and the reactions, I think, that we should care about. But his passing actually isn't too bad, right? As you can see there, that was quite a dangerous pass, I feel like. But still, we managed to put it off, not a problem. He's going to look for that ball in there, isn't he? Most definitely. The other thing I found that I really like about him, guys, is the fact that he's insanely good in the air. You know, he's insanely good in the air. That was really good defending from him there, too, by the way. This game, man, I can't get any control at all here. Come on, Yashin, easy. Oh, my God, boys. I think we saw another block plus there, by the way. Messy game so far. Good to test out Yashin, because this guy's very, very good. But, yeah, it's hard to kind of review centre-backs the way I play. I do try my best to review them, but everybody will just say I'm crap in the comment section, right? Because of the way I do defend. But it's the way I've always defended. It's really aggressive and all of that kind of stuff. Here we go again. You have to be careful here. We've tracked it all the way. Do you see how quickly he turned there, though, guys? I think that is so nice. You know, the problem with reviewing a centre-back like this is now our fourth or fifth really good centre-back in a short space of time. I do think Akanji is probably the best centre-back on the game, unless you have the team of the years still. But I think Yashin actually sits there with Akanji. You know, as you're more like defensive-minded defender, if that makes any sense. As we're just kind of strolling through this game against this really sweaty player. Really sweaty player. I don't know what I've done there. I had a bit of a brain fart. I'm having a bit of a brain fart full stop here, actually. He's not off. He's not off. He's not off. His recoveries are so good, though, man. Oh, maybe not there, though. Oh, bad, bad, bad recovery that time. This guy's so good with the left stick dribbling. Yashin just is able to jockey so quickly, though, guys, that it does feel like jockey plus, but it's not just that, right? And then you've got to account for the fact that he's got crazy good defending. He's got really, really good physicals. He's like one of the most physical defenders on the game. And this is a good test for him as well, up against Harry Kane, who is also a physical monster on this game here. I think right there, guys, you see how I was able to play that so quickly? I think that is because of reactions and composure. More so to do with reactions. And I'm giving this ball back to this guy quite a lot so he can test. Jesus, man. He's so good on the left sticking, isn't he? This guy. He's a really, really boring player, but he is very good at left stick dribbling. It's nice again from Yashin. Do you see how good that recovery was, guys? You know, I overcommitted like crazy, and still, he was still able to help me out there. And we're through on goal with Isak. I'm going to bait him out here. Oh, stop it. Oh, what a goal. What a goal that is. And that is from the counter-attack, from that crazy, crazy bit of defending from Yashin. This is also what I really like about him. Not showcased there, sadly. He's very good at driving out. You could certainly go for an anchor on this card. It seems like a bit of a waste that how good his physicals are. But you can go for an anchor on this card if you want to boost up. I think it gives a better boost to certain defensive stats. I don't think his defensive AI is bad by any stretch. In fact, I think it's really, really good. If you play with AI, you'll like this card. If you play manually with your defenders, like I do, you'll also really, really like this card, in my opinion. Love it. I love it. Always going to have to be there again for us, though. And he is, guys. Oh, I can't get out at the minute. Literally cannot get out. There we go. There we go. I mean, there you go, guys, right? That is Yashin in a nutshell. Won the ball back a few times for us there. And then the pass out was really, really poor each time. I don't think it was from him, though. More to do with how poor the other passes were out. So it's not like his passing, Jesus, has been, you know, bad in this game. It's also not insane. I will admit to that. It isn't insane. It really isn't. But it's good enough, especially when you also add in the fact that he's got great reactions and composure. It really is a card that will do you a solid defensively. Of course, he can't do anything else, right? Doesn't really have the best dribbling. It's more about the jockeying for a big man that I really like about this card. He turns so quickly, and it just allows you to kind of, for me personally, right, the way I defend, I'm going to try and explain this best I can, is I defend by baiting out the lane, so it kind of opens up the passing opportunity for the opponent, and I'll quickly come back across to cover that lane. Yashin is really, really good for that. Really good for that, because of how quick he can turn, how good his tackles are, how good his reactions and composure are. It just is a mix of all of the best things on the game for a defender. And I think the only thing he's really missing is good passing. And his ability to turn is unbelievable. Oh my God. That is the power of block plus, I guess. But I'm not often doing them kind of slides. So I guess I don't get to see that too much. That was insane, though. That was absolutely insane. He's going to look for that. Go on, Yashin. Oh, did you see how quickly, guys, I managed to get him turned around there? It is wild how good his jockeying is. Yashin is there as well. Free header. Oh, my God. I mean, guys... how mad is that? Oh, my God. And you can feel that kind of stuff off the ball with his jockeying. Oh, I love it. Oh. Oh, my God, guys. Do you see that recovery speed? This is what else I like about him, guys. His ability to drive into space. I mean, that's crazy, isn't it? Got to score that, really. Passing's good. You know, it is actually not bad. Oh, Yashin, nice, man. Easy for Yashin. What a read and what a challenge as well. Do you see the way we baited that out there, guys? He's just a recovery demon. Pass terrible there. Just a recovery demon, though, guys. Oh, my word. Nice again, Yashin. Real nice. Good outball that time as well. It's a good chance, this too. Zerks. Bonk. Bonk. Oh. Nice. Good positioning there from Yashin. Really nice. Nice, Yashin. What a step up that was. For me personally, guys, after using this card for now, probably like 30 games, obviously two games here on the loan, but this is one of them SBCs that will make your team better unless you've got the Team of the Year Renard. Or Team of the Year Virgil, so on and so forth. I actually think he's better than Millie Bright, personally. I think he's better than Gold Virgil. I think he's better than the Inform Virgils and the Winter Wildcard Virgil. In my personal opinion, of course, make sure you are listening to what I am saying. I think he's better than this Ricardo Carvalho as well, guys. I personally would say that the two SBCs that we've had over the last few days with Akanji, who's going to be getting a plus one, and Lev Yashin are two of the best centre-backs on the game. And if you don't have the Team of the Years, guys, these two need to be your backline. I'm not capping when I say that. Don't worry about his low defending. He's got anticipate, he's got intercept. Doesn't matter too much. The thing that makes this card insane for me personally is I control my centre-backs an awful lot. And he is so good on the jockeying. He is really, really fast in-game as well, with great reactions and composure. His recoveries are the best thing I have ever used on FC24. He recovers so fast because of his agility balance. His tackles are so good because of anticipate and intercept and his reactions and composure. The only thing you might struggle with a little bit on this card is his passing is very, very poor for the most part. It's okay at times, but it's just inconsistent. So you have to be really, really careful with his passes out. But you do get kind of let off by that with the composure. It means that he can find a pass under pressure, essentially. You know, he has got crazy good tackles. Block plus isn't actually as bad as I thought it was. He's got a massive body type in game, guys. And I think whilst this card is insanely expensive, you are looking at a crazy, crazy centre-back here that I think a lot of people should be considering in their team. If you want to know who he's better than, if you've got someone in your team that you want me to... you know, kind of compare Yashin to, let me know in the comment section. Let's go and take a look at a few, guys. Let's go and take a look at a few. So, Virgil, Ruben, Renard, all better. I think, fair to say as well, Maldini's better. I think Millie Bright, I'm taking Yashin over Millie Bright. I'm taking Rio over Yashin, probably. I'm taking this Yashin over these two Maldinis as well. Not over company, 100%. But then when we get from here and lower, bar Lucio, I think this is... probably one of the best centre-backs on the game. Yes, he's expensive, but what did you expect? He is going to get a 9.8 out of 10 from me, guys. Value for him is terrible, so we're not even going to bother raising that. But this card is absolutely amazing in-game. Let me know if you consider completing him. And yeah, just take my word for it, guys. A monster, monster card. But if you have enjoyed today's video, leave a like, subscribe to the channel, turn on the bell, subscribe to the player review. But guys, that's going to be it for me for now. So take care.